Devil's Peak, here by close to Rose Memorial, by the slopes, and I just find a few fynbos that is also used medicinally, and I did find yalikrysum. The Khoza name for yalikrysum is Mpepo. Afrikaans name for it is Khoigut. Why Khoigut? It comes from the indigenous people, the Khoi and the Sun. Actually, what they did is, they made their beds from this herb, this plant, and it was to repel mosquitoes, insects, and so forth. And today we use a futon and different types of mattresses. But our indigenous people, they did use the alicrysum, the Mpepo. And it was a good, perfect flea repellent, tick repellent. They could sleep well at night without being bothered by certain insects. And it's also been used internally for medicinal purpose. Very good for ladies that got menstruation cramps. It's very good. You infuse it in boiling water. You drink it twice, thrice a day, and it helps with menstruation and various women problems like menopause. You can also give it for hot flushes. And it's also very good for headaches, and it's very good for migraines and so forth. And externally, you can actually use it for cuts and for wounds and use it as a wound dresser. And what also very mystic part of this plant is our indigenous healers. What they do is they burn it, and it's also to clean your house, your space, against negative energies and so forth. So a lot of indigenous healers, they burn it in their house or where they're clearing the house for people, and it's also very good for energy clearer to bring in good energies and reject bad vibes, bad energies. And yeah, that is salicrysum, and it's also part of our indigenous flora, and we are actually number 6 of the floral kingdoms of the world. We're actually the smallest, but we are the most diverse in the world. I think we surpasses the Amazon, Brazil, and so forth. And yeah, welcome to our medicinal fynbos of the Cape Floral Kingdom. We're going to speak about various types of medicinal plants, and we're going to start off with our yallikrysum. And as the series goes on, we will discuss various medicinal plants that you can grow in your garden and that you can use safe medicinally. Okay, the seed in this plant, in the yallikrysum, it normally comes off when the flower comes. And when the flower comes, it normally comes in these small buds like these. This is the seed. After it flower, and this is the seed, it's in the bud, it's very small. It's in there. And it falls off after flowering, and it regrows again. And it's actually an easy grower, it's a fast grower as well. Like I said, and it's been used as ground covers in people's gardens. And the flower comes in the middle of summer, the beginning, yeah, in the middle of summer till the end of summer. You can't actually just pick herbs, medicinal fynbos on the mountains. You have to have a permit. You must have belong to a forum, the Indigenous Healers Forum. We're very strict because some of our fynbos is very endangered. A lot of them are endangered, and we just try to protect our fynbos. And it's a very beautiful fynbos that we've got in our region. And yeah, it's not, you can't just pick up. There's very strict laws against it, and you can get it at various nurseries. As the program goes, we're going to visit some nurseries where you can obtain yallikrysum in Mpepo, and that you can plant in your garden. And it can regrow, and that is also very good for sustainability, for sustainable development, and that is what we need in our Cape Floral Kingdom. African herb man, wilding her horn, just concentrate, cause heaven lives on. Retired slave man will look with a scorn. Here's the flower that is forming now, and after it's flowered, the seed will fall out after the flowering, like we saw on the previous one. When it's finished flowering, then the seed, and then the seed will fall out, and it will regrow again, and it will germinate. So here's the flower buds that is starting now. And after flowering, our seeds come. African herb man, seize your time. I'm taking illusion on the edge of my mind. I'm taking losers down through my life, down through my life. Yeah. Yes, I'm quickly at to bar. Where you can get all nutritional supplements, and you can get the medicinal plants here as well. We spoke earlier on of the Mpepo, so I've got the yallikrysum here, so I'm just going to do a demo on how to prepare the herbs. Okay, so it's not necessary to boil it, but you can do it if you want to, but for the safest way is not to boil it. Okay, first of all, you have to have the scissors, then you cut the packet open. Okay, you take about a quarter teaspoon, okay, a quarter teaspoon to a half a teaspoon, okay. You put it in your cup, okay, and then you got your freshly boiled water, okay, then you put it in the cup. And then you let it stand for 10 to 20 minutes, okay, you can add honey in. We've got raw honey that you can choose, or organic honey, or natural sweetener like xylitol or so forth. And you can add it with, and you can drink it twice or thrice a day. And that can help you with your menstruation cramps, it can help you with your migraines, it can help you with stomach cramps, okay? And the wound dresser, you just apply it where the cut is. And that's how you prepare it. It's very easy, it's very simple. It's like baking a cup of rooibos tea. So at the waterfront at the Healthy Life, you can get all the various medicinal fynbos that we'll find in the Cape Floral Kingdom. You'll find it here at the Healthy Life store. And here, as you can see, and you infuse it in boiling water. You drink it twice, thrice a day, and is what our ancestors did use. And the knowledge has been passed on as well from generation to generation. Some of the indigenous people, they used to burn it as well to clear the space for bad vibes, bad energy. And you just take a small piece, okay? If you have a prayer, your own prayer, you don't need a specific prayer, but any prayer that you feel in your heart and in your mind, you pray and you walk around in your house, and so you disperse of the negative energy. And you just take a little bit, you light it like this, and it burns like this. African herbal, wilding her on. Just concentrate, cause heaven lives on. Retired slave men will look with the scorn, with a transplanted heart. Mystic vibes, here we go.
Okay.
Goedemiddag, goedemorgen pa, hoe gaan het? Goed, goed pa. Ja, no, we have to have the good vibes. Okay, so are we ready?
Okay.
So yeah, people, here we are with the jellikrysum. You will find it in various nurseries. Now, if you want to grow jellikrysum, you shouldn't go to the mountains and pick it because it's not good. Rather go to various nurseries like the Vandenberg Garden Village. You will find it in pellets like this, or you'll find it in black bags. It's very easy to grow and it's very much water wise as well. Now, if you can even grow it in a pot. What you should do is, if you do it in a pot, put some potting soil in it, put jellikrysum in the pot, cover it and just water it. Now you can put it half sun, half shade or semi-shade. And it's also very much a fast grower as well, and it's indigenous, and that is so cool about the jellikrysum. Now if you want to put it in the ground, okay, you don't also need bone meal, you don't need fertilizer, you maybe need fynbo soil, and the soil that you have, you can mix it, put it in the ground, water it, it will grow. If you want to cover a patch, jellikrysum is the way to go. It's a very good ground cover, it's fast growing, and it's also evergreen. So jellikrysum is a very good plant, and it's also very beautiful, and it's indigenous, and it's part of our Cape Floral Kingdom. Jellikrysum. So yeah, here's the jellikrysum. The English name for it is everlasting, or African sage. Of course, our brother and sister call it Mpepo. African herbal, wilding her on. Just concentrate, cause heaven lives on. Retired slave men will look with the scorn, with a transplanted heart. Guess how quick they had to part. The remembrance of today is the sad feeling. Slave men will look with the scorn.
transplanted heart.
If I weep, they have to cry.
Leave me.